Another one, I was in Syria like 2 years ago, and we interviewed a woman who, so she was an Arab, from an Arab area, but she joined the Kurdish female forces. They, the YPJ, they have like a whole female militia. And anyway, so she lived in a village, you know, she's Muslim, normal Muslim, chill, whatever. Then ISIS come to the village when they're taking over Syria, and they're like, right, you have to wear head to toe niqab, you know, you're not allowed, whatever. So she's like, right, best just do as we're told, because they were just murdering people's fathers and brothers in the street if they didn't. So she's wearing you know, head to toe niqab. And then she was like, she liked fashion. So even with all this ISIS stuff, she's like, you know what, I'll wear my nice belt under it. You know, they probably won't see it. And I don't know what happened, maybe it come untucked, but she's at the market and she was telling us that they saw the belt, and I think it had like studs on it or whatever. So they like arrested her for wearing a studded belt. So they arrest her, and she said they took her in. Actually, the darkest part of this was her brother joined ISIS. And I think he made sure that she stayed in prison, if I remember right. Yeah, I have to check the footage. But anyway, so she gets arrested, she gets put into prison, and the punishment is to be whipped on her back with, like, you know, I can't remember how many times, but she said it was just unbelievably brutal, like, just whipped and whipped till she's bleeding, like, her whole back's welted, you know, she's scarred for life, and then just for wearing a belt. And that was, like, really hard to listen to, it was really dark, and eventually they released her. If I remember right, she did something else. I think she wore like a bracelet and got whipped for that again. Anyway, the that was hard, but then the amazing kind of arc to the story was that she said when the Kurdish forces, she was there hearing all this fighting, and she said she kind of comes out of the basement, you know, as a bombshell or whatever, and she sees like female fighters, like women with like long hair, like braided and whatever, and she's like, what? Like what? Like, oh, like the Kurds are here. And she said they liberated the area. And she just went, they were like, right, we're going to look after you now, you can go wherever you want, whatever, all week. And she was like, no, I'm joining. And she just joined straight away. So she joined the militia, the female militia. She was like, look, these lot whipped me. And they said, okay, well, you have to take a code name. That's how like everybody does in their thing. And she's Arab, but she said, I'm taking the code name Kurdistan. And they were like, no, you know, you don't have to do that. Like, and she was like, no, like, I am, because you lot have, like, you know, freed me. And I was like, wow, what an amazing story. And then I was like, well, what happened? You know, our brother's at ISIS. I was like, what happened if you see your brother? She goes, I'll kill him without any question. And I was like, good. You know what I mean? Like, and that's like a very like heavy like interview. But like, you know, when you realize like, wow, like my life is just chill compared. You know what I mean? Like, this is what annoys me. You see a lot of this moaning about politics and this, that and the other. And I just think some of you like over here in the West, like, just have got no idea what's happening. You know what I mean? So good interviews like that. It's good to get the story out there. It's good for everybody to see it. But obviously for me, I do take that to heart. And I'm like, right, yeah, like that's a good, it's a grounding thing. You know what I mean? Humility, you know? So, yeah.